Hello, fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Purdue Boilermakers and the Northwestern Wildcats. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Well, we certainly have a great matchup for fans to keep an eye on today at the center position. Both players are capable of taking this game over.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. The Boilermakers snap up the loose tip and move it up the floor. The Boilermakers are number six in the polls right now, Dick.
One thing that every team in the top 25 has is good guard play.
Bust the jumper. Running that Princeton offense here.
Hey, it's a great system if all five guys are on the same pitch.
Had his shot rejected. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. They're set to throw it in from the side. They move it into the front court.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Off the mark. Offensively, they get into their zone motion.
He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Shots off the mark.
Up and inside.
Goes up for two. He drains the shot. The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
For two, makes it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. He goes up with it. Off the mark. The shooting guard takes the feed. Gave it up. For the swatted away. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts the three. Missed it. Out of bounds and a change of possession. How about this one, Dick?
Hey, up, up, up and away, Mr. Nessler. That's how you go scoring to the basket.
Coach is trying to get the players to think defense now. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Shoots from the top of the key. It won't fall. Long handles the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Try to swat it from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Got it in the low block. Goes up for two. Got it. On the dribble, gives it up. gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Great defensive play. Anticipating well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Number five takes the pass. Nails the jumper. Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under. They just can't seem to get a nice look at the goal tonight.
They have to be patient on offense and find some easy hoops.
On the dribble, gives it up. For two, it's good. The Wildcats are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in a high post.
You know, it's a good offense when you can position a player at the high post and then have the ball delivered to a scoring threat.
Knocks it down. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Saves it. Law receives the ball. Gave it up. In the lane. Can't connect. Both teams looking to get things going here.
Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Oh, yes. How about that play? They went through the high post again.
Well, they manufactured that basket through the high post. I guarantee you that they work on it every day in practice.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He manages to keep it in play. On the dribble, gives it up. Buries it home.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Off the glass and no good. Law handles the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Backcourt violation call.
Little bit of a mental lapse by the offense that time, Dick. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Gave it up. Alley-oop.
They called for the lob and threw it down, baby.
On the outside. He tries to knock down the three. Gets the J to fall. The perimeter. He puts up the tray. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
On the outside. He bombs from outside. Can't seem to find the stroke from the arc, Dick.
And they're missing wide open looks too, Brad.
They're working around the arc. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
Out on the left wing with a jumper. Scorches the net with a J.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Number 50 picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
It's important to have kids like this on your team. They've had a year of experience, but they are still hungry to prove themselves to their teammates and coaches.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Up in the nylon.
Number 35 coming in for the first time tonight.
He will give this defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
Great job of dribbling around that trap.
He wasn't afraid of that trap.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a push guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Cross court. He launches a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Boilermakers will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
They try to really get balanced in that they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high-percentage shots.
Momentary look from three-point land. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
He shows the sweet touch. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the wing. Tries for two. No good from the field. Long handles the feed. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Lobs it. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Turns it over. 8 minutes left on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Buried it. The Boilermakers are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
Certain offense is required that the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
Gave it up. Yeah. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, it's been a treat to watch him out there. He understands what he needs to do, which occasionally means taking a shot and other times looking for his teammate. So many teams get bumped on screens when you inbounds the ball from the baseline.
Off it. Nice rejection. Nice shot. Looking for a good shot. And the slam. About 7 minutes remaining. And now setting up here in their Princeton offense.
Oh, that Princeton offense can drive you bananas. Look at the cuts to the goal. They spread the court, great spacing, great execution. 15 to 17 feet apart on each possession.
Goes up. Nope. He gets the rebound.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket, drains it. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper. They got it. The Wildcats are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
We're at the 6 minute. He gets the rejection. Number 50 looks to be down emotionally.
Well, he knows he's not getting it done, and emotionally, it's bringing him down. Coming inside.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Looking for a good shot. That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and he can utilize that drop step. It's like a reverse pivot move.
He can't get the hoop to fall. They're working around the perimeter. Jumper knocks it down. Moving it around the perimeter. We're at the 5 minute mark. Tries for two. You betcha. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. 10 to shoot. Hurries it to beat the clock. Goes in. Gave it up. Unloads a three. The missed shot. The Wildcats can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
And here's a look at the freshman.
Well, he's out there seeing a lot of this for the first time. It's going to be important that he gets the right direction and guidance from his teammates and coaching staff.
Misses the second shot. The defensive rebound coming the other way.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Working it around the perimeter with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Off the mark. Cross court. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. He hits the shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For two, drains the shot. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Nothing like having those legs, man, when you bounce right off the floor.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries a three. Nails the J. We're at the 2 minute mark. Long receives the pass. He shoots from downtown. Busts the J. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
A little half court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading. Try to go inside.
For the bucket. Great shot. Cross court. Tries for two. He misses it. On the outside. About a minute remaining. Trying to feed the low block. Tries the three. Knocked it down. They work the perimeter. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Goes up with it.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Shot clock is dead. The shooting guard with the ball. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive play.
The Boilermakers trail by one. Northwestern really showed no signs of rust with their shooting in the first half, Dick.
They certainly did, and their offensive execution was near perfection. Keeping it up will be the key.
Well, let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far, Dick.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen. Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Looks like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale. On the outside. And a slam.
At least you make the highlights letting him do that.
On the left side. He pulls up with a jumper. Gets the J to fall. They'll work it around the arc. Takes the jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. The Wildcats are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nessler. The high post is a goal line if you can make the right decisions with the ball. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Can't connect. Tickles a twine. Cross court. Turnaround jumper. The shot won't fall. Long receives the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. For two, he makes the shot. Now trying to feed the low block for the bucket. Gets it to go. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
Long getting after it and saves it. Working around the perimeter. Tries for two. Goes. Out on the wing. Gave it up. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Pushes it up.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Inside. He attempts the jump shot, nails the jumper. Zone motion now. Out on the wing. Looking for a good shot.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition. Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Scorches the net. Cross court. With a deep shot from outside. Poor shooting behind that arc lately, Dick.
Yeah, they can't seem to find their stroke yet, Brad.
Time to pick up the defense here now. He puts up the J. Missed it. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Timeout on the floor. ESPN's coverage of the NCAA will continue after this. Let's get back out on the floor.
No numbers, no numbers.
Dump it inside.
Shoots. Doesn't go.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops. He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Looking for a good shot. And now the fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, he uses the ball really well, too, in terms of putting it to the deck, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
They work it around the perimeter. Number five is called for the foul. First personal foul. The Wildcats have been getting contributions from a whole bunch of players here today.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work with one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel involved.
The Boilermakers move into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. The Wildcats have a player spotting up on the three. Moving it around the perimeter. 10 to shoot. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
So the inbound play on the baseline. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The power forward gets the ball. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Going to move it around the perimeter.
Nice hop.
Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
It's great seeing those types of plays. That's team basketball.
The Boilermakers set up in their zone motion. Haas handles the pass. There's a double team waiting there. Cross court. Ten to shoot. For two. That's good. balanced teams, Dick, what are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defensive end. Other balanced teams may play in the half-court offensively and really look to pressure their opponents in the full court.
On the right side.
There's the trap.
And score it. Puts up the jumper. Knocks it down. Number 50 is whistled for the foul. Second personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
They've got him trapped. Can't elude the trap.
Are you kidding me? He tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Brad.
And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket, and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Working it around the perimeter. And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Scorches the net with a J.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And the fans are going wild.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important, mental toughness.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. This is the big time. And he missed. Number 31 takes the pass. Puts up the tray. Knocked it down. And a timeout's called. We got a break in the action. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball coverage. Timeout call. We'll get back to the action right after this. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
We saw moments ago just how excited the coaching staff was. They've been preaching execution on offense and tough, hard-nosed defense. It seems like his words, excitement, and enthusiasm are paying off.
Coaches are expected to win, and obviously this makes the profession that much more stressful.
As a coach, you're always expected to do well. But when you're depending on other people to deliver, namely student athletes, it's a bit more stressful. That's why preparation is the key. Coaches have to ensure that their teams are prepared.
Perfectly executed. Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Gets the J to fall. On the outside. Perimeter. Number five is charged and a chance to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, good second effort to stay with it right there. Did a great job attacking the defense.
To the charity stripe. Cashed it in. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
Fed the low block. For the bucket. There was no doubt about that one. The shooting guard with the ball. He unloads a three. Nope. 7 minutes left on the game clock.
Turnover by the senior.
The shooting guard takes the feed. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
On the outside.
Shoot it. High step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Baryshnikov in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. They'll work it around the arc. We're at the 6 minute mark.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Well, offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
Dumps it in with the J. He misses the J. The small forward handles the pass. Momentary look from three-point land. Ten seconds. With the big shot. The shot's off target. 5 minutes left in the game clock. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Trying to pack it inside. He shoots from the top of the key. Now with 10 to shoot. And back they come the other way. Turnaround jumper. The missed shot. Goes up for two. Was that beautiful or what? Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He pulls up with a jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Boilermakers are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
Hey, the clock nor the score is in their favor. They're going to have to switch up their style and play completely up-tempo. They should be looking to press and score quickly, Brad.
Out on the wing. Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. He misses the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. He gets the shot to fall. Looking for a good shot. Here's the three ball. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Down inside, tries for two, lays it up. For two. Two with a lay-in. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that. Look at that spacing.
He shoots from left of the circle. Rims out. Two minutes left on the game clock. Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job in his footwork to create the drop step.
Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Step to the line for the free throw. Misses the first. Gets the second. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
He may be in some trouble here. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Zone offense now. On the dribble, gives it up. Blocked.
Dump it inside.
Throws it up.
He called for the hoop, then went up, and got it, baby.
Cross court. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Tries for two with the layup. Looking for a good shot. We have a backcourt violation.
Mistakes like that can add up in games like this.
They work it around the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta.
They need the foul here.
The small forward with the ball.
All you need is a score and a stop to have a chance.
We've got a break in the action, folks. Stay tuned for more ESPN coverage of the NCAA. court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Talk about pressure and expectations from the head coaching perspective.
Hey, Brad, those two things have got a lot of coaches going gray and losing their hair, becoming bald like me, baby. I've got nothing but respect for coaches who've been successful and have been in the business for 20-plus years. That's an accomplishment.
We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
Shot clock is dead. Jumper! This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
The man is off the charts, Brad.
Stops the clock again. And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely.
Makes the second. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
And we're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
And the clock stopped with a foul. To the line. He misses it. He grabs the rebound. And we've got a change in possession here. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He'll go to the line. He makes the front end of the one and one. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Lots of rim, but not in. Thank you. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
He looks for three. Can't get the shot to go. And the clock stopped with a foul. He is going to the line. Makes the foul shot. Hits the second. The small forward with the ball. There they come with a double team to stop it. This is the big time, and he can't hit the shot. And here, Dick, we have our players of the game.
Just two great players with some fantastic performances here tonight.